What is up, guys? My name is Robin, and welcome to Life is Strange on my channel, RobzarrGoesRawr. Now, I've had my eye on this game for a while. I kind of have an idea of what it's about. It's another episodic thing, so I think the episodes are roughly 2 hours each. So we'll do an episode per video. Yeah, I've heard it's good. I've been meaning to play this for a while, actually. I was actually going to play it for the channel switched formats. I'm glad I didn't. I'm glad I waited. I think it'll be better now. Save game one. Game not started. Oh yeah, that's right. I tested it out. I'll just go on save game two just in case I miss anything. I'm pretty sure all the episodes have been released now, yeah. Got them all on here. Right, let's go. Life is Strange is a story-based game that features player choice. The consequences of all your in-game actions and decisions will impact the past, present, and future. Choose wisely. Ooh. Hello. Before I go anywhere, I forgot to check subtitles. My subtitles, yes. By Square Enix. I'm a big fan of Square Enix games, actually. I love the Infamous series. And quite similar, the reason I'm playing this now is because I'm still kind of adapting to the new format of the channel. And this is kind of quite similar to Until Dawn, which I just finished on Monday. I think it has some kind of butterfly effect meaning to it. Not quite as strong as Until Dawn did, but in the same way that the Telltale games adapt to your gameplay.
Holy shit.
I'm a big fan of Telltale games, actually. But a lot of development teams seem to be releasing these. Sonic.
Whoa. That was so
surreal. These are Sonic games now.
Film Little Pieces of Time.
I like them.
But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep. And that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller?
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by the...
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
The eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? And frankly, it's...
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I do love my analog camera.
Seriously, though,
I should take a quick picture now.
And capture you in a moment of desperation.
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century.
Isn't that too easy?
But I like it old school.
What if Arbus chose to capture people...
I haven't kept up with my journal as much as I should. If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
Oh, so this is like the inventory menu, I guess. Where's my journal? Episode 1. Chrysalis. I think that says. I don't know.
She had a brilliant eye.
If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
How do I... Okay. No, it goes all the way back. That's where I am now. Got accepted into Blackwell Academy. If words could dance, this would be a rave. Blah, 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 blah. I'm not going to read through all the diary. Shit is crazy here. First entry from my new dorm. No, blah, 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 blah. Where are we at now? Okay, October. October, my favourite month. The best weather of the year. I love watching the leaves change colour, turning into tiny flames. But it's still too damn hot, thanks global warming, and I can't bust out on the big coats and sweaters or scary movies yet. Soon, Kate let me borrow The October Country by Ray Bradbury. I haven't read much of him, which caused Warren to almost revoke my geek cred before I held up my back copy of Battle Royale. I like this girl already. But he nails the autumn atmosphere of small towns. The last time I wore a Halloween costume was with Chloe. I have pictures in one of my old albums. I should find a real Halloween party to crash so I can experience some social mingling. Or it's that, or the Vortex Club Stroke Fest swimming party. Or is that Backstroke Fest? You're so punny, Max. At least I'm trying to climb out of my cocoon. I shouldn't expect my life to completely change after a few weeks of Blackwell Academy, as my parents love telling me on a loop, you have all the time in the world. Okay. So that's Max, that's who I assume we're playing as. My name is Max Caulfield, blah 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 blah. Not only is Mark Chesson one of the best teachers, he's also my teacher. Probably got a little bit of a teacher crush. Blah 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 blah. Oh, who's this? Victoria Chase. The elite of Blackwell Academy and a total bitch. Lovely. Okay, that's where we're at on there. This must be like... Okay. Dad. Have a very special 18th birthday. You're an adult now, but you're still a little girl. Check your account. Don't blow up once. Thanks, Dad. Okay, you okay? And blah blah blah. Happy birthday, Maxine. Can't believe it's not 18th birthday. Okay, I think he probably has some kind of crush on her. Okay.
So, she could have taken another approach.
Let's take a selfie.
I'm not a big fan of her work. I prefer Robert Frank.
Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry. I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
So you're asking me. I did know.
But I kind of forgot.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody
out,
here
dudes.
Who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
What a bitch.
Very good, Victoria. The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius. You can find out all about him in your textbook, or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
This is like the cliche of cliche-ness in
Victoria
high
doesn't
school.
Waste a second kissing ass. I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell.
Greenlit. 5,200. Wow. Everybody in class
is turning in a photo, so even her school books are gift wrapped. I can't believe she made fun of me in class. What is she, 15 years old? Huh. This might make a cool shot.
Everyday Heroes is an important cultural event. And I want to represent Blackwell Academy.
You have just by participating, by putting yourself out there in the world. Now, no matter who wins, this is just a bump on
macro-wise.
A bigger road. I don't want anybody to feel excluded from
Hi, Kate.
Process, but
oh.
I also want everybody
Hi,
to
Max.
Know that this photographic world is not for everybody.
I hope I didn't embarrass you. You seem quiet today.
Everybody should have a chance.
Well, how would I have embarrassed her? Let's go for quiet.
You seem quiet today.
Just thinking too much.
Victoria has already won. Wanna go grab a cup of tea?
I hear that. Wanna go grab a cup of tea and bitch about life?
Capote.
Thanks, but not today. I have to go over homework.
No worries. Let's hang later.
Sure.
Looks like somebody was already working on this. Cool.
NeoVay. It's like Photoshop. Ooh. Printer?
That printer is amazing. I'd love to see how it reproduces my pictures. I love seeing Mr. Jefferson's awesome photos on these magazine covers.
Stormy, I can hear you whining through my headphones. Chill out.
That was amazing when Mr. Jefferson took a class picture the first week. Even though I didn't want to be in the picture at all, it was fairly fucking cool to watch him at work framing us.
What, Stormy? Sorry guys, my cat's being whiny. He's a whiny bear.
Damn, they have carbon fiber tripods here. The ball head even has a pan lock? God, I'm such a photo nerd.
I think you're just a nerd in general, actually, Max. Right, shall we leave the classroom, or is there anything else for me to look at? Victoria, Mr. Jefferson...
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Do I have to? I didn't have any time.
Do I have to? I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max! You're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
Come on, Stormy. Victoria.
Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me.
Alright, Stormy. Hang on, guys. I gotta pick my cat up. He wants his cuddles. You want a cuddle bear? Oh, hello. Come on. You want a cuddle or not? Nope. Bye then.
You can never escape the lighthouse
Whoa,
here.
Stop whining. I just fed you.
Even in pictures, the forest around here always looks mysterious. Man, he even has the best plasma HDTV for a class monitor. Can't can't wait to watch some more documentaries on this bad boy.
Well, yeah, let's leave.
So cool that we can check these out anytime. The Decisive Moment by Henri Cartier-Bresson? That's rare. Annie Leibovitz.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
I'm not paying
you always.
Welcome to the real world.
Just cute?
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture.
Because Max wants everybody to see how hip she is. She plays it so sharp.
I need a serious timeout in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's so fucking boring.
Why are you just going against the wall then if it's...
She's so fucking shy.
Try to go to the bathroom. Play the credits.
I love that picture of Mom and Dad. Hello, Jack. Kiss, kiss. Andy, you look totally fabulous, as usual.
Imagine a world without you. American girls, I'd like to be part of the world around you.
I wish October would last forever.
I like October. It's my favorite.
Watching
one.
The world from the bright
side. There's one Halloween and two my
good thing I left my AK at home.
Where am I going? Principal's office.
To all of you, American girls in the moon.
It looks like she's been gone for months.
No one can
Rachel Hamlin, wasn't it the name that was scratched into the desk?
American girls like dollies with shiny smiles and plastic bunnies.
Nerd alert, this poster has Warren written all over it.
American.
Empty, good. Nobody can see my meltdown, except for me.
Rachel Amber is a bitch. What is going
now,
on?
Now, who would bother to write that crap?
I feel like this has got some kind of meaning. I hate Victoria Chase. Ditto.
This poster must drive Kate people to have sex. God.
Absence makes the heart grow fonder. You can still love and learn without sex. Time is on your side, so use common sense and use it.
I'm good to flow. Thanks.
Oh, nice. Poster.
The last time I got a flu shot, I got the flu. Fuck you. I feel like the universe is taunting me everywhere I go today. It all started with that bizarro dream in class. Am I going crazy?
Probably.
Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it.
Oh no, Max! I think it was a cool photo. It's a flutter bag.
When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
Slowly. Photo. This is the girls' bathroom, dickhead.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, oh, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing
shit.
Around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No!
Oh my god, she was on the menu screen, so she must, like, have some kind of importance.
Whoa! What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
As he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us.
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color.
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now,
shit.
Can you give me an example of a photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Captured the human condition in black and white.
Okay, if I'm crazy, I might as well go all the way.
Bueller.
Can I actually reverse time?
Go, Victoria. Why
would that
us?
Really be the first thing you would want to show?
I did it.
Can you give me
I
an
actually
example
did
of a
it.
Photographer who perfectly captured the
human
condition
time
in black
machine.
And white? Anybody? Bueller?
Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arvis?
Because of her images of hopeless faces.
When I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question. If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Kids call a
you just, like,
selfie.
Rewound time. You
a dumb
know
word
for
a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
of course,
this.
As you all know, the
it's
photo
real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation.
So
was
I can go
first
back in time.
For selfie expression.
What if that girl so, isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point
can
remains
I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography. For
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
I feel sick. I have to use the bathroom.
I'm sorry, but I really have to use the bathroom.
Nice try, Max. But you're not going to get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody
who knows this?
Jefferson wants to keep me after class. And I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind again and give him the right answer?
It's like I mean to learn
people's faces, making them The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail and-
Oh no, I need to go back. That's faster.
Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation,
it's gonna take a while for me to get used to.
Tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits.
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular. mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of everyone. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you're not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Oh.
Yes, Victoria, you still have to do your homework this week. Even if you're submitting your... I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Not avoiding it, not sure if I have one.
I'm not avoiding, just...
biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Exactly.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
It's true.
Go on now. Don't let me stop you.
Press R1 to quickly undo your previous action using R1.
Yes, Victoria, you still have to do your homework.
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's futures...
I'm on top of
John Lennon said...
I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers, good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
So this is like the best way to kiss ass in school.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please. I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy. Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Yeah.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing
around
with!
What are you gonna do? What am I...
What are you doing?
Don't
come on, put that thing down!
Tell me what to do!
Wowzer, it's
Max! You're going to get hurt!
To control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody
would ever... I need the hammer to break it open!
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Holy shit! I can't let this happen! If I can reverse time again, I can help her.
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You're going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Success!
Another shitty day!
That did not happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on?
Do
not freak out.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone, and please turn off that alarm since that's your job.
Boom. What an asshole.
Thank you.
You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max.
I don't think
or
you can
have
right
you
now.
Done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
Hide the truth, report Nathan. Hide the truth, report Nathan. Hide the truth, report Nathan. Would he even believe me if I reported Nathan? I'm gonna try it. I can always go back.
I just saw Nathan Prescott waving a gun around in the girls' room.
Nathan Prescott? You sure?
Yes. He was in the bathroom talking to himself with a gun. I saw everything. He was babbling like crazy.
Okay, slow down. Slow down. So now you saw this without him seeing you.
I was hiding behind a stall. I have the right to be there. It's the girls' room.
I know. I just want to be completely clear what happened. Mr. Prescott happens to be from the town's most distinguished family and one of Blackwell's most honored students. So it's hard for me to see him brandishing a weapon in the girls' bathroom. So what happened next?
Then he left. I ran out here wondering what to do. Are you gonna bust him?
This is a serious charge. I'll look into the matter personally. Thank you for bringing it to my attention.
That's
okay,
it?
He seems not an asshole.
After what I told
you? We'll continue this discussion later in my office. Please go outside with the rest of your class now, Miss Caulfield.
Of course this academic drone won't do anything, since the Prescott family owns Blackwell now. Should I rewind and change my story?
No, I'm gonna leave it. I don't want to go back on too many of my choices, because unless it's like... it affects the story, like, progressing, because I want it to be my own playthrough.
With Nathan Prescott, please come to the front office. Thank you.
Hayden. Rick.
Hi, Brooke.
Let me guess. You want to fly my drone?
I'd love to. Is this legal?
I'd love to. I love planes and balloons and...
This is neither. Do you know what a drone really is?
A weapon, right?
You read too many conspiracy sites. This might be too complicated for you. Funny. Warren said you were smart. Please, step back.
Hi, Max. Can you get my flash drive? I need some space. Hello, sorry running late, insane day. Meet you in the lot, looking cool. See you. My camera will be ready. See you shortly. Hope so.
Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive.
Is these the dorms? These are the swimming pools. Missing person's poster, leaflet.
Warren's waiting for me and his flash drive in the parking lot, so I better get back to my dorm.
I don't know where the dorms are, little lady. We're on the other side if that's the swimming pool, the other way. This is cool. I like the art style.
What's up, Daniel?
Oh, hi, Max. Could I, ask you a question? Would you mind letting me sketch you? I do put my sketches on Facebook, though.
I'd be honored. Oh, yeah,
I'd be honored, Daniel. Makes me feel like a muse.
Funny you should say that. I was just thinking about my real muse. Rachel Amber.
You knew her? What happened to her? Had to avoid her posters, start drawing.
You knew her?
No, but once she asked me to draw her portrait, oh, she was a natural.
So what happened to her? There's gotta be a story.
She just stopped coming to class. Some people said she ran away. Some say she jumped off a cliff. I just hope she's okay.
Hard to avoid her posters all over campus.
Kills me to see her sweet face used as a crime photo. She had a good heart.
Okay, why don't you start drawing me? Even though I must be a step down from Rachel.
No way, you're a good substitute, Muse.
Oh, he draws. Is he drawing with pen?
Oh, that's a good posture.
Oh, no, is that a pen? Looks like he's drawing with pen. I draw with pen.
Good. Good.
Best portrait ever.
This action will have consequences. What, I was being nice to somebody? Evan.
Evan's portfolio always looks so uber pro. I'd love to see his photos in there. Hey, Evan. Mind if I check out your cool portfolio?
Let's see if you're worthy of it, Max. You'll have to answer a simple question. Who photographed the famous falling soldier?
Isn't it Robert Dorneau?
Oh my. You can't even tell the difference between street photography and photojournalism. Mm. No portfolio peak for you.
Back it up.
Hey, Evan.
Let's see if you're worthy of it.
So it wasn't him.
Gotta be Eugene Smith.
Well, they both were famous war photographer images, but you should know the difference. Good try. Wrong answer.
Back it up. I want to see this portfolio.
Hey, Ev.
Skip.
Steve McCurry?
Unless he could travel back in time. McCurry was born 5 years after the falling soldier picture. McCurry also shoots in color. In other words, no portfolio.
Okay, fourth time lucky because it's the only answer left. Oh no, he's got all the way back.
Hey,
it's gonna take
Evan.
A lot of getting used to. What?
Robert Capa, of course. I love his work, despite the controversy about that photo.
My, my. This quiet child knows things.
That's why I'm here.
You're a kindred spirit, Max. Would you care for a perusal of my portfolio? It's not a privilege I grant to many.
I'd be honored, sir. These photos are great. And Rachel Amber's face is mesmerizing.
Oh, that was not worth it. Anyway, dormitories.
Come on, Logan, bring it, Brock. Yeah.
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive.
Oh. Hi, Max.
How are you doing?
Fantastic. I'm by myself reading Chicklet. Pretty soon I'll be bonding with Victoria at the Vortex Club.
I think you're better off reading Chicklet.
Good point. Now if you'll excuse me.
Okay.
Oh, look. It's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled. Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Books, bitch.
Oh, yes, books. Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way.
Ladder.
I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way.
So, how do I do that?
Okay, now where exactly is the sprinkler valve?
Yeah. What do I do?
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Success? Maybe?
Do you understand English? Get lost.
What a bitch. What am I supposed to be doing right now?
There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window.
None shall pass. Capiche?
What do I do? Well, let's just see where Samuel goes. Maybe if I...
This main sprinkler valve looks easy enough to use.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, we did that. Same.
Nice, bro.
Can I go through here? No. So what, I gotta wait for Samuel to put the paint in on the top and then move the sprinklers, and maybe that would knock the sprinklers and get covered in paint? That's my best guess.
Nice.
Okay, so that's there now. Still there. There is definitely a point. It's giving me a point to go back to, so. Oh, so the sprinklers aren't on yet. I get it. We wait for Samuel to go up there, then put the sprinklers on. I get it. Come on, Samuel, speed it up. Thank you, sir.
Nice, bro.
Now we do the sprinklers. No, it's not done.
This main sprinkler valve looks easy enough to use.
Okay. Alright, okay, now we can go. Yeah, we can still use it. Come on, Samuel! Lip hint?
Awesome.
No, it won't let me use it. Why? Let's try using it as he's going up the stairs.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Oh, what am I gonna do?
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just
what? What do I do?
So, do you understand?
Yeah. Awesome.
Guys, I am super confuzzled. Yeah, I get
that. I must have missed something. I should rewind.
Have I got to throw something at it? I know I have to use the paint tin, but I don't know how.
I better rewind. This main sprinkler valve looks easy enough to use.
I don't get it. I get I need to tip the paint over them, I do. I just don't know what I have to do it.
none shall pass. Do you understand English? Get lost.
Guys, am I being dumb? I know!
I must have missed something. I should rewind.
Maybe I need to get the sprinklers. Maybe I need to get the ladder wet.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
You'd think the sprinklers would get Samuel when he goes up the ladder.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Nice!
Obviously not doing something previous to him.
What the hell?
He's not there. Alright. Be right back, guys. I'm gonna have to look up a walkthrough. Where's the time bucket? Okay, guys, so... it's saying I'm doing it right.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yes, we've seen that.
Sweet.
Is it interact with the paint bucket somehow, it says? Tampa.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Okie dokie. Use.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water.
Okay. We've tampered with the bucket, this is different. Okay, so... oh, snap!
No fucking
way! You okay, Victoria?
Oh, Samuel, sorry. Yeah. Wet paint is not good
oh,
for
oh, poor hey, Samuel.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo!
Hold on, hold on. We'll get some towels, we'll be right back.
So move your ass before I dry.
It worked! Don't mess with Max, bitches. Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
Make fun of comfort. I'm not gonna make fun of her. That makes me as bad as her.
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
It was. But there'll be another.
Well, you always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
No.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max. I hope those sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on me.
Oh, dude.
You deserve a better shot. Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck yourselfie.
That was mean, but pretty funny.
Just one of those days, you know?
I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
Au revoir.
No.
Okay, we can now
proceed. Victoria
probably
played me.
We took so long.
Read this edition is broken backwards. Bathroom, fire alarm, missing person's poster. Blah, blah, blah. Max's room. Slate. She hasn't got anything on hers.
Home, sweet home. My favorite cocoon. Philip Lorca de Corsia, my man. I don't think I could take my camera to those places. Look at that shot. I love Julia Cameron's Victorian vibe. Talk about analog cameras. Ah, Dolly, what a fantastic eye. He could truly freeze time.
Bite me. Lol. Laptop, sticky note.
Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note.
Hey girl, I borrowed your hard drive so I can watch some flicks while I study. If you need it back, just track me down in my room.
Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's
room. Daniel has so much talent. I hope nobody hates on it just because it's me. I am so addicted to this site.
Look at these vintage beauties. Warren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here.
Okey-dokey.
One day I'll organize my film collection. One day I'll get an actual... You are thirsty. I'm the worst baby mama. Drink up.
My film collection is organized in alphabetical order and series order. So you know. Clothes, cookies. What's in here?
Hard to believe I'm 18 now. I'm lucky my parents enabled my photo habit into adulthood.
Right, now I have to find Dana's room.
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Okay, so it's that one. That was easy.
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell.
So stupid.
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet, Mason?
Juliet Mason.
That was truly sad. Thanks for your concern, Max Caulfield. By the way, Juliet Watson.
Uh-huh.
Hey, Juliet.
Juliet, this is so stupid.
Juliet Watson, you be nice.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do.
Thanks. I locked Dana in because she was sexting Zach, my boyfriend. Unbelievable.
Would Dana do that?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext. And Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything. But I bet Victoria
I'm not letting her out until she tells the truth.
Okay, back it up.
Hey, Juliet.
Oh, yes, Max.
Hey, now, Juliet, this is so stupid.
Juliet Watson.
I'm flattered.
Of course I do.
Thanks. I locked Dana in because she...
You are ridiculous.
How do you know that? Would Dana do that? How do you know that?
How do you know?
Victoria Chase. You know her.
You could say that. But why would Dana go after your boyfriend?
According to Victoria, Dana would do...
According to Victoria...
She saw the sext.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything. But I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in...
Okay, so what? I reckon I have to go to Victoria's room. Victoria's room. Enter. I'm not gonna stay, we're just gonna check.
I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
Okay, where's printer? Printer! Print email. Take.
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
Okay.
Juliet, email. Read this.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No. But I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Okie dokie. This is so weird. Like,
almost done.
Beyond.
Get the flash drive and then I'll go see Warren.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
Oh, that's sad. What's sad is I also do that. Don't mind waiting here forever. I love this parking lot, I can count all the cars. USB 2. All my USBs, USB 3s I think. High grade. Alright, parking lot.
Fuck this shit!
Ow! That hurt!
Damn, I better rewind.
Uh-huh.
Alyssa, move your head!
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
Hell yeah, you did. Main building. I think the parking lot was just out of the main building, wasn't it? Go to the parking lot. It's weird that it's got these
so
invisible
don't think
walls
I'm
in
blind.
Between.
I see
like,
everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand
campus?
What I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Intervene, take photo. Intervene. Although
hey,
photo might have improved.
Why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Hmm, he's an ass.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you.
It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate. I felt like an everyday
hero. Go to a parking lot.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
Indeed. Right. That must be Warren over there. Another missing poster.
Yo, Max, check it out.
Warren's car.
Look at Warren and his Wayback Machine. He's a...
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
He so has a crush on her.
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I don't want to talk.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
Daniel posted it online. We know Daniel posted it online.
You
We've
can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw.
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
I've seen that.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
Faster pussycat kill kill.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill kill.
Russ Mayer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I don't want to
speak about it. This is kind of a crazy day for me. I mean, I literally think I'm going crazy.
I may be a pest, but I'm a good listener.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal, now. Answer me, bitch!
I told him the truth. A student had a gun.
No, you told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
And did what? Give you a stern lecture?
Nobody. Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
He is crazy.
You should talk to somebody, Nathan.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
I could call the police.
Do it! The Prescotts own the pigs here.
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that!
Or that whore right in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Lauren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk ass
Warren.
Get in there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Oh, poor Warren.
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing. Hopefully nothing.
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beatdown for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess.
It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country.
Not gonna say
and
anything
my favorite
Mark
teacher, Mark
Jefferson.
Jefferson.
That would be like.
So you came back to Arcadia anyway. For a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I wanted to, I'm sorry. Yeah, that was kind of jerky. I'm just gonna apologize.
I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
I can understand why she'd be a little bit pissed off, but come on.
Haven't heard that one in a while.
It's a camera.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage. And he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Oh, they're like besties. I knew she had to have something to do with it, because she was on the cover, like the intro screen, to start the game up.
Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home. My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Medicate. You druggy. Bag, box, closet. Where's less stereo? Stereo, hi-fi.
It won't play without any power.
Power strip. Switch on. Okay.
Now, let's see what kind of music Chloe is into these days. So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers. I think this junk swallowed her discs.
Probably.
She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned.
TV box set. That's pictures.
Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close.
Were. See, not around anymore then.
Man, I remember this furniture. This postcard is from Rachel Ember.
Miss you, wish you were here, Rach.
We had such a blast drawing these together.
She's a killer. Okay, where's all the CDs?
And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross. Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair. Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height.
Okay. Where's the CDs? Okay.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
So, who is she? Do you mind talking about her?
Rachel Ember. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
Rachel took my place. I never forgot.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
See, why? What about your mom? So what happened?
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know? What about her parents?
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Poor Chloe. Where was the stereo? There it is. CD.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Okay. Garage will be downstairs, unless you go downstairs. Weird transitions between same parts of house. One message from Kate. Thanks again, Max, for helping me. No problem, that guy is an asshole. Yes, he is.
I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Joy still works at Two Wells Diner. Best damn burgers in Arcadia. I better get one soon.
I'm like, I know I'm quiet right now, I'm just trying to take it all in. Because
I should be able to find the tools I need here.
I don't know how to explain it. I feel like it's like
nothing. This is
like
so lame.
A big story. I'm just trying to make sure I fully understand it right now.
Shit! Butterfingers!
Back it up. Back it up good and proper. There we go. Let's not look at them. Cupboard open. You're somewhere. I'm nowhere. Laptop, you.
No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
True. Just being nosy.
These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera. Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this?
Weird.
I'm singing songs about the future.
Cupboard closed, look.
Wowzer, a map of Blackwell Academy. I wonder why.
It's like he's trying to get some security shiz up in there too. I'll close the cupboard.
Boom, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them.
Turn on, maybe I'll wiggle them down.
That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Let's see. The tools are stuck, out of reach, and no way in hell to get them.
Okay,
brilliant, Max. Brilliant.
Okay, the tools are stuck in there. Alright, so we push the cardboard under. The tools fall on the cardboard. Let me pull the cardboard out.
Mad skills, Max. I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks.
Let's do it.
Goodbye to my Santa Monica dream.
I like the soundtrack. Bathroom picture. Open. Wrong way. That must be Chloe's room. Desk tools. Time to fix the camera up.
So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, I wasn't there. I was there.
I was there.
She knows I was there.
Hiding in the corner. Damn, you're a ninja. A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
Wasn't sure, no.
I wasn't sure.
I know I look a lot different.
I was scared, too. I couldn't see straight.
I don't blame you, Max.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit, not really.
Just a bit.
There's no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Like
who?
Like anybody. Stop stalling, sister.
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max.
You're welcome. My camera's still busted. And your stepdad's a creepy stalker.
I, know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera.
Photos. Chloe's cool. I like the characters.
This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max. Turn it off.
I thought that was in my house, that banging.
Dude, the music's not even on! Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing?
Chloe, closet, go to the closet. Hide in the closet.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Get smart. Just let me in.
Shit.
Now. Please.
1 second.
Under
my
the bed.
Bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier.
Where am I gonna freaking hide, Chloe?
Open this door.
I'm not a kid anymore. I can't hide under the bed. Where else?
I'll give you exactly 3 seconds to open the door. One.
Where am I gonna hide?
Two, three.
Shit.
What's going on in here? Why is she here?
None of your business.
I don't like strangers here.
Stop freaking. She's not a stranger. This is my friend.
Great. Another one of your friends. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh, God. I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control.
Wait. Is that grass? You've been toking up again in here?
Oh, yeah. Guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth.
That's the guy from the...
It's not my pot. It's from Max.
Is this true?
Take the blame. Blame Chloe. Take the blame. Just take it.
Yeah. My pot.
So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now, do
you? Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
What a fucking asshole.
Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win. Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
Okay.
Man, that did not go well for me. If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
So, Chloe's stepdad is a security guard. He has cameras all around their house. And he's basically a freaky psycho. That's all I got, freaky psycho.
Isn't this awesome sauce? Totally reminds me of when we were kids.
Awesome sauce, I say that.
Come
nice
on,
and lame.
Slowpoke! Hold on.
It's right up there with the groovy potato.
I haven't been here in forever. So why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa. This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today. I feel like I'm in my nightmare again.
We never did get to the lighthouse in the nightmare. One message from Warren. Earth to Max, your White Knight Warren is here. I know you were worried about me. I owe you thanks for today. I'll call you back later. Okay, I swear. No problem. You still have to tell me a big secret. What does Keck
Earth is so lucky. They can always escape.
Where is Chloe?
Wowzer. Chloe drew that to mark our tree fort, so we'd always be able to find each other in case of emergency.
Aww. Oh, there's Chloe. Trust no one.
How long has that been here? Clearly, the Bigfoots are everywhere. Too bad it's locked. I remember racing up and down the steps.
Campfire.
Looks like the youth of Arcadia Bay still come up here to party.
Probably.
I never made it. Sure you don't want to be alone?
Have a seat, Pete.
My pleasure, you're in a good mood.
You're in a good mood.
Hated me like half an hour
ago. Seeing my step dork get played makes me happy.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
You freaked out on Kate. I should have taken his photo. He freaked out on Kate.
He freaked out on poor Kate Marsh today.
I know her. She's cool. Only that prick would bully her.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
I wanted to, not me.
You know, I wanted to, but I realized I have enough mystery in my life.
I'd like to find out. I bet he's got some serious porn in there.
Ugh.
Good thing he didn't look. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
I knew you didn't know. Chloe, your house is under surveillance.
What are you talking about?
There are cameras all over the house. I saw it on a monitor in the garage.
I knew it! He's so hella fucking paranoid! I'll keep this a secret for now.
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable.
Got black
everybody in this town
least.
Knows everybody's secrets.
Even yours?
Even yours?
Not anymore.
So what do you have on Nathan?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
What about Nathan? How much? I don't give a fuck about Nathan. He's weird.
$3,000 plus interest. And before I could get a chunk of that from Nathan, he dosed my drink with some shit.
God, Chloe. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
That is fucked up. I'm so furious. I am furious.
I am furious? I can't even speak. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
Let's call the police. He's still dangerous. Let's not call the police
He's
yet.
Still dangerous, Chloe.
Because Chloe's
not just
still
to you.
Like,
oh, good thing you notified the principal.
Like,
I feel
the
safer
wrong of
already.
The law here, kinda.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max. This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
Nice.
Oh no! Not again!
What are these, like,
why
premonitions?
Is this happening to me? Why am I here again?
I reckon this is the future. Is that my Patronus? Am I Harry Potter?
Is Chloe still up there?
Oh, sweet child of mine. That is a freaking boulder. Let's go this way. Mother of God. Okay, now where do I go?
I've never seen a storm like this in Oregon.
Where does I go? Oh, I get it. Oh, you can teleport yourself. Oh, I get it. So I can now go back to before the tree fell. Nice. That's cool.
Are you going to lead me to the Sword of Gryffindor? Mother of God! Let's go over here.
Oh my lord! The tornado is back!
I am so confused. Newspaper, is that what I wanted me to read?
October 11th? Is this Friday? That's only 4 days away!
So it is the future.
Oh no. The tornado is headed straight for the town. Chloe, you're here. I'm back. Oh my lord, this is real. It's real. Oh man, this sucks.
Max, what's going on? You totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years. You just zoned.
No, I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But high, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max, start from the beginning. Tell me everything.
Nice. Okay guys, so that's the end of episode 1 of Life is Strange. What if I can skip over the credits? Yeah, I can't. I'm not online at the moment. When I'm recording this, I still don't have internet, so... You've put Nathan, you comforted Victoria, you inverted. Intervened to help out Kate, you took the blame for Chloe. Where would I have hidden? I couldn't find anywhere to hide. You let Daniel draw your portrait. You didn't sign Miss Grant's petition. I didn't know I could. You helped Alyssa. You didn't erase Kate's slate. You watered your plant.
who didn't touch Dana's pregnancy test. I didn't even see that. Who didn't touch Victoria's photos. Who didn't write on a dirty RV. Okay. You let the bird die. I didn't know I could let the bird live. You didn't break Chloe's snow globe. I didn't know I could. You didn't leave any evidence. I did that. You didn't read David's files. Okay. That must be on the next episode. Episode 2, Out of Time. Right, that's going to be in the next video coming out on Friday. Now, I'm going to put my controller down. I want to say something about this game. I know I was quiet during that walkthrough. This is a huge story. Like, it is massive. And I'm just, like I said, I'm just trying to take everything in. So we have the butterfly effect via time travel, which is cool. We haven't seen that before. It is kind of similar to Until Dawn. Obviously, it's not a horror. But the basic concept is the same. I really love the art of it. And it seems like a much more down-to-earth, actual, realistic adaptation of a school setting. But it still has the cliche part of it, you know, you got your jocks, you got your pretty girls, you got your geeks, you know, and that's really cool, because playing as the main character, she seems a lot more realistic in her personality, even though, like, with Until Dawn, and I know I'm comparing them a lot, but they are similar. With Until Dawn, the graphics, phenomenal, you know, the characters looked like people, but I didn't feel like I could relate to the characters, because they were just cliche characters, and that is just what they were. With this game, it feels like the character that I play as is so down to earth and actually real, despite the graphical differences, that it's a really fresh take on everything, and it makes, you know, obviously the story is make-believe, you know, we can't travel back in time, we don't have superpowers, but it gives it that real feel of realness because of Max's character and how she interacts with everyone else, and that's a lot to do with the choices that you can make. So in the next episode, I'm going to be much more involved with the walkthrough. I was just trying to take everything in and make sure I understand it, because there is a lot going on that just needs to be understood before I can make assumptions and before I can kind of say what I want to say. But I've played the first chapter now, and obviously I don't know what's going on with the rest, but I feel like I can connect with the character that I'm playing as, which is cool. And it is, like I say, it's a breath of fresh air to see an actual, like, the character you play as is the unpopular kid who is just that nerdy, don't really care what anyone thinks kind of girl, and he's just trying to get through class, and she's had this kind of like massive thing happen to her. Normally, if you play a video game, it happens to the popular kid, and you kind of play as like this tough guy or tough girl, and it's them that get these powers. And in this case, it's like the nerd is going to try and save the world, which is really cool. So yeah, I thoroughly enjoyed that first chapter. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Anyway, like I say, episode 2 will be out on Friday. I'm just going to play it right through, like I did with this one. And I'm going to play the game till it finishes. There's, I think, 4 or 5 episodes? Let me check. 5 episodes. So it'll continue throughout next week as well. It'll take up next week's walkthrough videos, and then we'll go on to something else. But I'm not going to focus on something else now, because this game is really cool. And yeah, despite the cheesiness that's behind it, that whole kind of your character feels very real makes up for the kind of, limitations that the rest of the game has. And the whole time travel thing is a really cool concept, and it actually makes you think about what you're doing, but at the same time you know that if you do fuck everything up you can go back. I'm not going to go back on my personal decisions as much as other people may have done, because I want it to be my own playthrough, and I want my decisions to be the ones that I make and they stick, unless of course it has to do with progression of the story. So yeah, that's it. I really enjoyed this, and I hope you guys did too. So that's going to be it from me. Make sure you keep an eye out for the rest of the videos that are coming out this week. And until the next time you hear from me, guys, as always, stay classy, gamers.